question is from X Rice Ball X.
It's different.
Hardcore.
On days when you know you can't perform at your fullest because you aren't fully recovered due to things like a poor night of sleep, should you just do mobility work, or is a lighter workout also okay?
I would say
yes and yes.
Or take a nap. seriously.
It depends. And I know some people hate when we say shit like that, but it really does depend on who I'm talking to, how I give this advice. Because we know for sure, and I know you guys have had most of your clients would look for excuses
right.
to not train and to not do things, right? Like mm-hmm. most of them need to get their ass in the gym. They need to be putting the work in. They sneeze once.
Oh my God, I think I'm coming down.
Something. Right. So I'm very careful and with when we give advice like, oh, you know, like you can overtrain, because it really does the top of the pocket. If I'm talking to the competitor, right, the guy or girl who is like addicted to working out and trains 7 days a week and rarely ever takes a day off, and they just totally overreached and super sore and they didn't get sleep last night, like 100%, I'm going where Sal started to go right there before I interrupted him. Like, yes, take a fucking nap. Take a mm-hmm. nap. You probably need a good day off and rest and fully recover. You'll probably come back the next day stronger than what you were before. But most people, I would probably encourage them to go in and do mobility or lighter work. Yes, sleep is one of the most important things, and if you're deprived of it, that is important. But so is staying probably consistent for most people.
Yeah, and there's two ways we can look at this. The one way is what would be best for your health and your body. If you had a bad night of sleep, what would be best for your health and your body would probably be to take a nap. On the other hand, we also have to look at, and this is where we always go to, how behaviors are made and how, you know, what's the most important long-term thing you could do in regards to fitness, which is just be consistent. So it reminds me of like the old school birth control pills where, you know, there's 30 pills in there or whatever, but there's 7 of them are fake, but they take them anyway. You know what I'm talking about? You guys remember these?
Yeah, the sugar ones.
7 of them are sugar pills. Now, why do they do that? Why do they put in 7 sugar pills when all they would have to do is tell the person to just stop taking your birth control for 7 days and then start
keep
taking
the ritual going?
It's the consistency, keeping the ball rolling. And so when we're speaking to behaviors, which is probably the most important thing to talk to, is not to lose momentum. Especially when you're first starting out or you're just starting to get consistent, it gets really hard to change. Once you start to change course, it gets hard to put yourself back on track. You know, it's like how many times have people worked out consistently, then gone on a business trip for a week or a vacation, or just gotten sick so they couldn't work out, and then they just never went back. It was hard to get the ball rolling again. So that's something you need to consider. If that's you, and you need to know yourself, okay? So, and you can't lie to yourself. If that's you, if you're that kind of person that consistency is very difficult and you're just now starting to find a little bit of rhythm and consistency, and then you had a bad night of sleep and you're like, gosh, you know, I'm just started getting back on track. It's still kind of difficult for me to be consistent. You probably don't want to miss the workout then. Go in there and go easy and do mobility work. It won't hurt you. It's not going to hurt you.
Or really light, like they said. I think both the options they list are fine. Like sometimes when I'm like that, I'll just go through and practice the skill. We talk so much about that on the show about, you know, look at an exercise and just try and work at it like a skill. So this might be a great day for that. This could be a good day where you go in and you're doing 50% of the load, but you're just working on movement patterns. And that's or just one thing, like just squatting or just deadlifting, but with really light weight and, you know, concentrating on the technique and spending that time. Or like your other suggestion, which is, you know, a full day of mobility. How often do people do that? Like how often does somebody just say, hey, I'm going to spend an entire hour of like stretching and mobility work? A lot of people don't mm-hmm. do that. And a lot of people could use that. And that's a lot more recuperative than going in and hammering the gym. But you have to, like to your point, Sal, you have to be honest with yourself.
Yeah. And here's the other thing too to consider with sleep is that some people can't nap or some people nap and then it affects their evening sleep. And light exercise or exercise in general does improve your sleep. So can you make up for your bad night of sleep? You can by having a better night of sleep the next night, and activity can contribute to that and can help you out. So if it's just one night, yeah, you know, go to the gym. Go to the gym and go easy. That would be what I would typically recommend, especially from a behavioral standpoint.